Y'all ready to hear some music?
Yeah.
Awesome. My name is EmiSunshine, and this is my band, The Rain, and we're going to do a brand new song from our upcoming Bluegrass album. This is called Ink and Paper. Wooden strings, wheels and stars. When I sing where you are, you might cry, you might dance, you might stare at who you are. I'll make you stare at who you are. Thank y'all so much. So this next one I'm going to do for you, it's the title track of this new album, this new bluegrass album I'm working on. And I started writing this one with a friend of mine named Leslie Satcher in Nashville. And she sat me down and she said that she had this whole idea planned for a song that she thought was just perfect for me. And I was just so happy to hear it. And we ended up writing the whole thing that day. And this is called Sideshow.
Billy eats fire, Jenny
Mary says Siamese twins can date, and Skip confesses he can't wait. We're too strange for the big ten, don't you know? Handlebar, wanna see a little baby monkey in a jar? Whoa, 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 whoa. We're too strange for the big ten, don't you know? Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, welcome to the sideshow. This is another one that I started writing with Leslie Satcher. She's really just such an amazing person and just such a good writer in general. And she has like these, she was like the biggest help when it came to this Bluegrass album. This is one of the songs that we wrote outside of the Bluegrass album. This is this one called Don't Worry About Me. Trouble that runs through me. Worry about yourself, don't worry about me. Need a little help now, getting to your knees. We all got sticks, we all got stones. Big glass houses, closet full of bones. Worry about yourself, don't worry about me. Worry about yourself, don't worry about me. Hate me. much. Oh, thank you. So this next one is also for the Bluegrass album. I started writing this one with my friend Fish Fisher. I started writing with him when he was like, maybe when I was like 40-something and he was like 11 or something. kidding. No, I'm stealing Fish's jokes now. It's gotten that bad. Now I'm stealing Bobby's, and it's just, I just speak for him now. All right. But this is one that we started writing a little while back, just simply about my roots as an artist, and this is what we came up with. It's called Trojan Horse. Such a good time out here tonight. It's my second time playing here, and I just really, really enjoy it. So thank y'all for having me back. I really appreciate it. And I'm so glad I got to bring my band with me too, which is my family. I got my dad over here on bass for me. Yeah. And my Uncle Bobby over here playing a kick and snare for us. Well, yeah, we have a good time, and for those of you who do not know, I've been writing and singing since I was around maybe 4 to 5 years old, and I've had just such a privilege to be able to, you know, partake in so much music and be able to, you know, write as much as I do and be taken seriously in the music industry that young. But I think that... with a bunch of these songs, I should go back to some of my older stuff too. And this is one from one of my later albums. This is called It's the title track. It's called Family Wars. And this came from just like people watching, I guess you could say. I'm the type of person is like, I don't really take inspiration from my own life as much for my music. I take it from other people. And I work off of that and create stories off of that with my mother a lot of times and various other co-writers. And with this one, it was just all about that and eavesdropping. I do that a lot. I like to eavesdrop on other people and then create songs. So if you're ever out there talking about your personal life out in the open, just please know that there could be a songwriter just in your midst, waiting.
Lurking.
Lurking.
You're a lurker.
No, but this is called Family Wars, and the second line of this song is not about my grandmother. Yeah. So. This next one here, I started writing with my really good friend and co-writer, Fish Fisher. And I guess we came up with this, just, it was an idea that we had, and it just became like this whole story that we were working on, just based off of like this idea of, it's always off of a woman who is very murderous, if we are going to write together. That is like what it is. And this song kind of embodies that one, the whole concept pretty well. And this is, it's called Scarecrow. It's one of our other murder ballads. This is on the Family Wars album.
Thank you.
time for a break now, ain't it?
Bobby, you need a break, Bob?
Well, you got the drummer standing up over here. I'm tired.
I've been sitting down.
All right. So I'm going to do the title track from my latest album. This is called Diamonds. Song that I started writing with Fish again. I started writing this with him, and we were at a Airbnb in Nashville, and we were just talking about how much we were not too happy with the music industry, and just were, you know, griping about things, and that kind of turned into a song. So this is called Judgment Day. I've got something inside of me, just can't be fixed. It's like the strangest dichotomy, two sides can't be mixed. Like a needle of bottom me, 'cause I'm running out of tricks. But I'm built like a sign. Crowd, thank y'all for coming out here tonight, and we're just so happy to be able to play music for you. yeah, it's sounding good too. Yeah, the sound is amazing, so thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I think now we should do a cover, Bobby. Yeah, sound good?
No.
No.
Stairway to Freebird.
Stairway to Freebird, that's pretty good. Rocky Top.
I'm gonna have to say no.
Wagon wheel. No.
No wagon wheel.
No.
I don't have a clue.
How about them four blondes?
She just asked me what key this was in, and I just said, I don't have a clue. So much for looking to your dad for answers there.
Okay.
So
it's the key you play it in.
We'll figure it out.
Sang it. Now I'm really being funny.
Sharing to kill the pain you may or may not. what's your pleasure? What's your thrill? Do you want the oxy or the fentanyl?
I said,
peculiar. So I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath and I get a real high and I scream to the top of my lungs, what's going on? And I said, hey, yeah, 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 hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? And I said, hey, yeah, 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 hey. This next one is another original. I started writing this one with my mom, and this is called Scars and Wings. I think this one was with was Matresa, yes. I was trying to make sure I was right on that before I said anything. Tell the night from day. Thank you all so much. So this next one is actually one that I started writing a little bit after I was on American Idol. I was with, I remember meeting a really cool guy there. His name was Malachi Mills. And we started talking about, you know, just different music that we liked. And we were friends on that show. So it was great to have somebody that I knew. But after it was all over, I remember, you know, we were just talking to him. And he was like, you want to write sometime? And we got together and we did. And he had this beautiful idea for a song, just simply just about loss. And this is called Josephine.
Why did you
That's a beautiful song. I really do like that one. Well, we're happy to be here in Crossville tonight. And while she's switching out instruments, I'll tell you all about, we've got some merchandise over here too, if anyone is interested in taking some of us home. You could purchase Bobby for a low, low price of a cup of coffee.
Oh, yeah? Happy birthday, eh? All right. Are we singing happy birthday?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right. Everybody want to participate?
Yeah.
All right. All right. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Donnie.
Hey.
Is that right? Don. Well, Donnie, hi. Happy birthday to you.
You got a mess there, don't you?
I got a mess.
What's going on here?
That's a pretty guitar, I'll tell you that.
Well, thank you.
Purple.
Purple.
It's all nice.
She's even got a purple chord, too, to go with it.
I do.
Nice. Would you say your favorite color is purple?
My favorite color is purple. Yeah. I do. Uh-huh. I love purple. What's your favorite color, Dad?
Green.
Ah. Makes sense. Why was it the wrong answer? Oh.
Hers is green. Blue.
Blue. Pink?
This is not the discussion for this moment.
Well, we're just having a little family discussion here about favorite colors. I like blue too. Blue's nice. It's soothing. It's soothing color. Nice.
So, you want to do an older cover?
I do.
Yeah, let's do. This is one of my favorite ones to do. This is called Rock, Salt, and Nails. Thank you. I just don't want to overpower everybody. Right. I worry about that kind of thing. Probably the first guitar I played to actually worry about that. By the banks of the river, where the willow hang down, and the wild birds they wobble with low moaning sound, way down in the heart. It was there I first listened to the lies that you told. Now I lie in my bed and I see your sweet face. In the past I remember, time can't erase. And the letter you your conscience still echoes my name. Now the nights are so lonely, Lord, and sorrow runs deep. And nothing is worse than these nights without sleep. Will I walk out of love? if the ladies were squirrels, with them high bushy tails, well, I load my shotgun with rocks or nails. Well, I load my shotgun. With rocks or nails.
This one you wrote with, did you write this at a retreat, I believe? Writer's retreat in Gatlinburg?
Yeah. I wrote this one with Jimmy Schott and Ethan Workman. We were doing a songwriter's retreat there at the Gatlinburg Inn, as we do. And it was a lot of fun for us, but this particular song was quite interesting because it was like three different parts from three different people that were not related to each other like at all. Like the lyrics weren't related to each other at all, but they just kind of fit just so well together within this song. But it was supposed to be just three separate songs. But it was really cool to be able to be like, oh, well, I have something in here that kind of relates to that. And then saying, oh, well, I have something in my book that relates to that. So it's really fun to get to collaborate with other writers because of that, because it creates such interesting songs.
But your knee is getting too hard. Say I ain't what I used to be. Hey honey, I still feel like me. You say that my cupboard is bare. Cupping up the flow and you don't even share. Shish, I grin, fall from your chin when you realize how empty you've been. Over and over, it's always the same.
What instrument are we going for this time, Miss Emmy?
upside down, Miss Emmy, on the bottom there. You gotta turn it over.
That's
there you go.
So, you want to do another one off of the new album?
Let us.
Yeah. Yes, this new album is going to be a bluegrass album, like, just centered around my ukulele. And I don't know if there are any bluegrass albums centered around ukulele, but I want to be at least one of the first ones.
There's one now.
But it's going to be fun. I think that within this album, there's a lot of stuff that's really connecting to my roots, and I feel like it's something that people have wanted for a little while out of my music. So I'm really glad that we got to do this. And this is one of the songs off of there. It is called The Boy I'll Never Love. And it is, I wrote this one with Leslie Satcher again. The majority of the songs on this album are going to be between me and her and my mother. And it was just such a perfect mix of people for this album. So this is called The Boy I'll Never Love.
Thank you.
one of the first songs I ever really wrote. This is called Little Blackbird. And yeah, this was a fun one for me. I don't know how like we started writing this one, but I was so small, I don't quite remember a lot of that stuff. But I do remember it being one of the first. And this is called Little Blackbird. My sweet gray son left early on that wagon train. When he left, I felt a warning, we'll not meet here again. Little blackbird sitting in the window, little blackbird, listen to me cry. Little blackbird sitting in the window, what shall I do? Sat outside upon the front porch, listening to the pain. Well, y'all have been just such a lovely crowd tonight. I want to thank you once more. Have y'all had a good time?
Yeah.
That's beautiful. I'm just very glad. This is our last one for the night, but it is. Unfortunately, it is. But I wanted to do you one of my favorite covers. I have to switch instruments for this one, but this is one of my favorite covers. This is a Tom Petty song. This one called Honeybee. That's my problem. No, sorry.
We was on the wrong channel.
Operator error up here. It's a. Don't blame it on the sound guy.
I was not.
How about give the sound guy a great round of applause?
Everything sounds great up here, and makes it so easy. Makes it easy to play, and just a joy to play. So yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
y'all once more for having us here. We really appreciate it. Y'all have been the best crowd. But yeah. Do one more?
Okay. Y'all want to hear one more? I think we got time, don't we? Do one more?
Yeah, sure. Table.